If you go to Brick Lane, it's worth having a look at the Everin Bakery, because here you'll find two traditions in one. Bagels are historically Jewish creations, but they're established East End fare as well. Only here, they're known as Beigals. Stephen Alder is one of the bakers at this family business, and if you want to see a speedy craftsman at work, just have a look at him.
It's good, isn't it?
It's all right.
Got a touch like a midwife. Let's have a go. Like that, is it?
Yep.
Round your hand, like that.
Way round.
Like that off there, like that. And just roll that bit like that. That's not bad, is it?
It's not bad. What's wrong with that? Not bad.
Give a fortune, let's have another go.
They're going to sell these, are they?
They're not too bad.
What about that bit?
5 o'clock in the morning, you coming?
I'll be here.
Bagels or Beigals, I don't think making them's for me. Now, this bakery turns out 36,000 a week, and here is the almost finished product.
Well, that's it then, is it?
That's a Beigal.
What happens now?
Now we fill them, sell them plain, you fill them with anything you want.
There you are, a freshly baked Beigal. Now, what could be more East End than that, eh? Except perhaps maybe eel pie and mash, which incidentally you eat with a spoon and a fork, no knife. Well, etiquette is very important in the East End.
Welcome to F. Cook & Sons, but known to everyone round here as Cooksies, one of the oldest eel pie and mash shops anywhere. I used to live on the stuff when I was a kid, and I tell you what, it's good to see it still going down a treat. You can have your food in any combination you like. Eels by themselves, pie and mash, or of course, eels pie and mash, followed by more pie and custard.
Hello, girls.
Hello.
How are you doing?
It's fruit pie and custard.
Have you had your pie and mash yet?
Yeah.
Well, you having pie afterwards and all?
Well, yeah. Kid, I've always had pie and mash, you know, and really enjoyed it.
Yeah,
it is clean. I've just had some myself.
How were they?
Very good. Excellent. Yeah. Chris, how is it that you can get this in the East End, but you can't get it in the West End?
Well, it's because the pie mash and jellied eels, stewed eels, is the traditional food of the East Ender.
Well, why do you think it's been such a tradition here?
Why? Well, I think in the old days, when things were a little bit tighter than they are now, it was a good, healthy, filling meal, and the people that lived in the area, they were sort of costermonger people, and it was a good, stable diet for quite a reasonable price.
Fred, is it as popular now as it ever was?
Oh, yes, very much so. Yes, the young generation coming up, yep. And the yuppie type of people that we've got round here now, they seem to have acquired the flavour for it.
You've got to kill them off somehow, I suppose.
Oh, that's a bit unkind, Joe. You don't look so bad on it anyway.
I love the stuff myself. I've had about four pies since I've been here. It's good stuff. How many eels do you reckon you flog a week?
Week?
Yeah.
Well, we use close on sort of 3/4 of a tonne of eels. A week.
Every week?
Yeah, so if you average that out at, say, 1/2 pound an eel, that's quite a few eels overall.
That's amazing, I can't believe it. What about, I bet you've got a few tons of spuds and all you get through.
Well, we use well over 1.5 tonnes of potatoes a week as well.
Yeah. Freddie, I've got to ask you, because, I mean, I know what it is, because I have it all the time, but liquor.
Parsley sauce.
Parsley sauce. Well, why, we always called it liquor. Why was
yeah,
that?
Yeah, right. A lot of people do call it liquor. It's a parsley sauce. It's a closely guarded secret how we actually make it and what we put into it. It causes a bit of mystery, but it turns a pie mash into a banquet.